Welcome to QuickBooks Online for Nonprofits. My name is Ufuma Ogaga. I am the owner of Goshen Bookkeeping and Consulting. I am a financial controller and a QuickBooks Pro Advisor, helping nonprofits to increase profitability one mission at a time. In today's tutorial, I will show you how to record bank deposits in QuickBooks Online. Before you record your physical bank deposit or your mobile check scanned deposit in QuickBooks Online, you need to create two separate deposit slips or make the deposit in your physical bank as two separate transactions. Once you do that, you have to come into QuickBooks Online to replicate the same process. The reason why you're separating it as two separate transactions is because you're tracking the restriction of your donation using location tracking in QuickBooks. So you're tracking whether your donations are restricted or whether they are unrestricted. Now, to create a bank deposit in QuickBooks Online, you will click on the Quick Create plus icon and then select Bank Deposit. Now, this is the bank deposit screen. Here you will see all of the payments as well as the sales receipt that you have entered inside of QuickBooks Online. Select the checking account to make the deposit to. Select the deposit date. Under where it says show payments for this division, filter by the without donor restrictions. So it will show you all of the deposits under that particular location. Check the box next to the customers that you want to make the deposit for. Since I have a Vanco Payment Solutions, which is a third-party merchant processor, I need to record the fees that comes out of the gross amount for the transaction before it gets to the bank account. So here I'm just creating a vendor name that just says bank charges and merchant fees. You can call this vendor name Vanco fees or PayPal fees. Here I'm creating a vendor name. Then I'm going to select my existing bank charges expense account. In the description, I am going to enter merchant processing fees, or you can enter Vanco processing fees or PayPal processing fees or any merchant processing name that you tend to use here. I'm selecting the same payment method that I have at the top, and I'm copying the reference number again from the top to the bottom. Here you're going to enter a negative amount, which is the fee that came out of the gross transaction for this online giving. And you're going to select the same class that you use for the online giving in this screen. At the bottom, you can enter a memo in the memo field, like, you know, if you have a bank deposit reference number, you can enter that in a memo. The cash back goes back to if you withheld petty cash from your physical deposit, you can enter it there. At the bottom where it says attachments, you can drag and drop a copy of that deposit that you're recording into that field. So once you go through everything, you can print a copy of this deposit, make it reoccurring, click save and close, or click save and new. I will click save and new. To record the second deposit, I am going to switch my location to with donor restrictions, and I'm going to check the box for the check that I entered before. I will leave the checking account and the date the same. At the bottom, I don't have to enter any merchant fees, so I'm going to leave that blank. And you can enter a memo if you want to in a memo field. You can add an attachment. I don't need to add any one of those two items, so I am going to click save and close to save this deposit. Thank you so much for watching.